My grandfather was a gereformeerde dominee, so we were reformeerd in those days, Calvinists. I emigrated to South Africa in 47. I was married by that time, and I'm still here. I practice as an attorney. I feel in Afrikaans I have a beroep. That is a roeping. I'm called to do that. And that's why I automatically help people without thinking about it. It's a sort of a habit which I inherited from my father. I remember we woke up one morning and heard planes and went to the radio and heard that the Germans were bombing the coast in Holland. 3 days later or so, they threatened to bomb Rotterdam flat. And that was it, and we saw the Germans coming in. Then the Nuremberg laws were applied to Holland, and all the Jewish people had to be dismissed. Shortly after that, they said the Jews must go to Germany to work there. Before that, they had to declare themselves as Jews. Now, the administration of the people in Holland was very exact. And they had a register called the Bevolkingsregister. There were some cases where it was not quite sure whether someone was a Jew or not. And so the Reichskommissar, he decided someone, some German, should supervise the decisions of the Interior Ministry. And he appointed a certain Dr. Kalmeier. He was an advocate in Germany. He was not a Nazi, luckily enough. So Kalmeier made a list of, had a list made of all the Portuguese Jews. That was called the Jewish list. And there was another list, a huge list of non-Portuguese who also for some reason applied for, and that was called the Kalmeier list. Now, after a while, the SS was complaining and they put some pressure on Kalmeier that the list should be shortened. So Kalmeier asked me whether I was prepared to do that, and I said to him, I must say, I don't agree with what you do with the Jews, but I'm an advocate and I do according to my profession. So long as it is not against my conscience, I'll professionally am prepared to help you. I got a room there in the department and I had access to all his files. I copied the stamps on letters and the signature or initials of that Dutch assistant. And after 2 or 3 weeks, I got the list from Amsterdam and I went to Kalmeier and set up Kalmeier. I went through all the files and there are quite a few that are not sufficient Portuguese. And here is a list. His list was suddenly a few hundred shorter. We had many people coming to us trying to prove that they were not Jews. I remember my first case which I tried was a young girl of, say, 4 or 5 years. She was Jewish. I went to Kalmeier and he looked at it. He said, no, that's not a good case. I dismiss it. I can't remember why I did it. I said to him, you are just like Herodes. He also killed children. And he was shocked, of course. He didn't expect such a reply. A little bit later, there was a decision signed by Kalmeier, by us, and she was safe. Now, after a while, there was pressure on Kalmeier again. Some Jews who were already in Westerbork had been declared non-Jews, and they looked very much like Jews. So the SS started saying all the cases should be re-investigated, and so he got some trouble there. Then he said, you know, it would be a good thing if before I decide on a case that I ask the Westerbork commandant for his comment. Would you prepare to go for me to Westerbork? Because he didn't like to have any direct business with the SS. He hated the SS. Then they had a sort of an office for Jewish assistance there. That was a German Jew, Dr. Ottenstein. Very good. We had a very good relationship. We called the person in question, briefed them what's happening, and then the next morning I went to Gemmeker and the people came there one at a time, and he dictated to his secretary his comments. And I went there more or less every second week for almost a year. There are lots of cases, of course. The one was a girl of, say, 3 years old or so with her mother, and the girl was blonde. Gemmeker was impressed. He was absolutely sure that she was not a Jew. The mother handed over the child to someone who would look after the child. Next week, the mother was gone. After the war, my partner went to Calmer. He was in jail then, and told him that we had cheated. And Calmer said, yes, I can believe it of you, but from Prose they never cheated. I don't know why.
Shel ha-mayim Berah